What exactly is Nusach Eretz Yisrael?
Nusach Eretz Yisrael is the Nusach, or the set of Nusachot, that we find both in the many, many fragments of ancient Sidurim that were found in the Cairo Geniza. It is well known that the Cairo Geniza was found in the attic above a shul, a synagogue in Cairo, in the old ancient city of Cairo, Fostat, where for centuries they had kept untouched ancient manuscripts that had simply fallen apart, old Sidurim, etc., etc., many kinds of texts and documents that were placed in the Geniza and left untouched for many, many centuries. And in that Geniza, those ancient materials, some of them dating back to the as early as the 9th and 10th centuries, we find a wealth of information, including many Sidurim, or parts of Sidurim, which present to us a Nusachot Tefillah, which till the finding of that Geniza were more or less unknown. More or less unknown in the sense that there was no living community of Jews in the world who were still using that Nusach, except for the Jews in that particular synagogue in Cairo, who till very recent times did maintain that Nusach of Tefillah, which they inherited from their forefathers who had emigrated to Egypt from Eretz Israel. We also have many snippets of the Tefillah and certain Barachot, such as Birkot Kriyat Shema, etc., in some of the works of Hazal, the Midrashei Halakha and Agadah, and the Talmud Yerushalmi, all of which stem from Eretz Yisrael. And by putting together all these sources, we can recreate and reconstitute an accurate version of the Tefillah as it was known, as it was recited, as it was taught in Eretz Yisrael, going back certainly to the period of the Talmud, if not even before that. And this Nusach was in use in Eretz Yisrael without a doubt, as we see, as it is quoted in the Talmud Yerushalmi and Midrashei Halakha Agadah Hazal. It was in use in Eretz Yisrael and surrounding countries during the time of the Gaonim, and even well into the Middle Ages. As a result, however, of the Crusades, the Crusaders invaded Eretz Yisrael, as is well known, at the end of the 11th century. And from that time on, the Jewish communities of Eretz Yisrael began to dwindle and eventually disappear. And that reality was unfortunately dealt more or less a death blow. But today we are able, with all the sources at our disposal, we are able to reconstruct a very accurate picture of Nusach Eretz Yisrael, which was a Nusach which existed side by side with the Nusach of the Tefillah, which existed in Bavel, in Babylon, in ancient times, in the time of the Mishnah, the time of the Talmud, in the time of the Geonim. And that Nusach of Bavel was the archetype which resulted in all the Nusachot with which we are familiar today, whether it be Ashkenazim, Sfaradim, Temanim. All those Nusachot are based on the Bavli prototype, whereas the Nusach of Eretz Yisrael was sidelined for historical reasons for a long time. And today we are able, Baruch Hashem, to revive it and bring it back to life.
Thank you, Rabbi Bar-Hayim. We would like to encourage our viewers to share these videos with friends and send in your responses. We would also like to suggest the following opportunity to our viewers. If you identify with Rabbi Bar-Hayim's message and would like to sponsor or dedicate a video interview with the rabbi in honor or memory of a loved one, if you would like to obtain Birkon Nusach Eretz Yisrael, or invite the rabbi for a speaking engagement, please email us at office@machonshilo.org.
If you are inspired by Rabbi Bar Chaim's message and would like to get involved in Torah Eretz Yisrael activities in your local area, please fill out the relevant form by going to the link which appears on the screen.